Okay, thank you. So I was talking about implementation of stack using a linked list. So this is the diagram you should remember whenever you want to implement stack using linked list. The element that you put the first will be placed at the bottom of the stack, right? So the element in this diagram is 25, which is the bottom of the stack. On top of it, we have 32. On top of that, we have 50. And the topmost element of this stack is 99. And it is pointed by the head node, and it is pointed by top pointer. So it means that instead of using start pointer or head pointer, the name is just changed, and the name we have given to that pointer is now top. So whenever you insert any elements into this stack, top will be incremented by one. And whenever you delete any element from the stack, any elements means always it is the topmost element will be deleted from the stack. Whenever you delete the element from the stack, top must be decremented by one. Consider that I want to delete the topmost element 99. If I delete 99, top must be shifted from 99 to 50, immediate next element into the linked list. So your linked list will look like this. This is your the topmost element 99, and the bottommost element is 25. And it is the end of your linked list, because 25's next part is null. The element which you insert first into the stack, when you implement it using linked list, the next part must be none of that particular node. Okay, so now there are three operations which you are going to perform on the stack, that is push, pop, and display. Push means you are inserting a node into the linked list, but where to insert it? At the top. Where is your top pointer right now? It is at the beginning. When you implement stack using linked list, where is your top pointer? It is at the beginning, start of the linked list. So whenever you put the new node inside the stack, it will be placed on the top of the stack. So what is this operation in single linked list? It is the operation of inserting a node at the beginning of the linked list. Inserting a new node at the beginning of the linked list. And that function name is insert first. So push operation is equals to insert first operation in case of single linked list. Now, another operation is pop operation. The topmost element will be deleted from the stack, and then the top pointer will be shifted from the topmost element to the immediate next element inside the linked list. Now, which operation from single linked list is equal to the pop operation here? If you delete 99, your top should be pointed should points to the node 50. It means that it is the operation of delete first. It is similar to the operation of delete first in the linked list. So remember this thing. In push function, we are going to write insert first operation code. Whereas when you write a code for pop function, we are going to write the same code that we have written for delete first operation in single linked list. And what about display? Display operation is very simple. We are going to display all the elements of the stack from top element to the till it reaches null value. So consider, suppose this is the example of your stack, how it will going to display the elements. First 99 will be displayed, then 50, then 32, and when it display 25, top becomes null. After displaying 25, top becomes null, and then you have to stop displaying the elements of the stack. So these are certain operations we are going to perform on the stack. Now I'll show you the code implementation of this stack using linked list. I have given the name to the file as stackll.c. Where it is, stackll. Yes, it is the last place, stackll.c. This is the code for implementing stack using linked list. Now, what comes to your mind first? Whenever you implement stack using linked list, you must have a node for linked list implementation, right? So a node has two parts. One is information part, and another is the next part. Information part will going to store the value of a node, whereas next part will going to store the address of the next node to which it is connected. It is similar to your single linked list implementation. If you see this node structure that I highlighted now, it is the same structure that I'm using in this code. A node which has two part. One is information part, and another is the next part. And there are three pointers I'm going to take into this role, and that is top, pointer P and pointer Q. So what is top pointer? It is a pointer which always points to the topmost element of the linked list or stack. Okay, what is the use of P pointer here in this program? We are going to use this P pointer to create a new node by the line P equal to malloc size of struct node. Okay, that is a standard line that I used in every program of implementation of linked lists. So I am going to use P pointer to create a new node. Then what is the use of Q pointer in this program? The Q pointer is used for traversing the linked list. To display a linked list, I need to traverse that linked list from first node to the last node. For that purpose, I used Q pointer. Then immediately after declaring the structure for this stack using linked list, you need to declare all the operations that you are going to perform on this stack. So the operations are push, pop, and display. They are just declared here. The coding is not defined here. Coding is there in the function definition. So we declare all the functions to the compiler before their use. After that, I will go to write the main program. In the main program, as soon as I enter into the main program, I will take one variable because I'm going to design a menu-driven program where there are four options I'm going to provide to the user into the menu card. There is one is push, two is pop, three is display, fourth is exit. To store the value of these options given by the user, I am going to use a ch variable. Then clear screen, you know what is the use of clear screen, to clear the screen and initially to tell the compiler that there is nothing inside the stack, your stack is empty. We'll assign top pointer to null. Whenever top pointer is assigned null, or whenever the value of the top pointer is null, I can say that stack is empty. Then this template is kept as it is, the same template that we have used in the implementation of stack using array. What is this? It is an infinite loop which allows us to perform this push, pop, display operations as many times as we want. And whenever I put option number 4, I will exit from this program. So as soon as I enter into this infinite loop, while loop, I will display menu card to the user. Then I'll check, take the option from the user. The option will be stored into the CH variable. And then according to the value of the CH variable, a switch case will shift to case, appropriate case, and it will execute the case code. After executing that case code, wherever it reaches to the break statement, it exits from the case. So suppose your option number one is entered, it will check, go to case one, execute push function and exit when it reaches to the break statement. Similarly, in case two, we are going to execute pop function. Then we exit from this case two with the help of this break statement. In case three, we are going to use a display function. Whenever we reaches to the break statement, we exit from case three. In case four, I just want to stop the program. So that's why I use exit one function here. And to use exit one function, you need to include one header file on top, that is hash include stdlib.h, standard library.h. Then what is default? It is going to handle the error of a switch case. See, if any other option apart from 1, 2, 3, 4 is entered by the user, it will show you the error message on the screen that it is an invalid choice. Please enter a valid choice. This is about the main program. Now we'll move to the code and definition of the functions. Now there are three functions in this program. One is push, another is pop, and third is display. Talking about push function, as I compare this coding of this push function with the implementation of stack using array, there I need to check the stack overflow condition. Here I need not have to check the stack overflow condition in case of linked list, because linked list is dynamic. There is no size limit. The size is not predefined. The size will be allocated to the node only when you create it. So there is no stack overflow condition in case of stack when you implement using linked list. So we'll directly create a new node with the help of the line P equal to malloc. I will create a new node directly. As soon as I enter into the push function, I create a new node by this line. Then I need to fill the information part and the next part of that node. So I'll ask the user, please enter the data part, and I store that data into P of info. After that, I put P of next equal to null. So these four lines of code will going to create a new node, as well as at the same time, it will put the data value into the information part, and next part is assigned as null. Then once the node is created, what is to be done now? We need to insert that node into the stack. So the condition must be checked before inserting. So the condition is, if top equals to null, it means if your stack is empty, then what to do? Then immediately you just assign top equals to P. It means P is the only node inside the stack, only value inside the stack pointed by top pointer. Else you just assign P of next equal to top and top equal to P. It means you are adding a new node at the beginning. Correct. You are adding a new node at the beginning. You are storing the address of the topmost element into P of next. Newly created node next part will going to store the address of the top pointer. After that, I want to make the newly created node as the topmost element of the stack. I will write the next line, top equals to P. So how many times I can do this? N number of times. I can insert n number of elements into this stack. So this is about push function. Then another function is pop function. It is used to delete the topmost element from the stack. So I'm going to use one more pointer here, which allow me to delete that node. So that pointer name is Q. Q equal to top. If Q equal to null, I'll check the condition first. Then I'll print stack is empty. It means underflow condition has to be checked always before performing pop operation. If you do not check underflow condition, then there will be some errors or logical errors. If Q pointer is assigned null value, then I can say that stack is empty. Else, if the topmost element display the value of that node, are you going to display the topmost element value by the pointer top of info? Top of info will going to display the topmost element value inside the stack. Then immediately shift the top pointer, because we want to delete the topmost element. After deleting topmost element, it must shift to the immediate next element. Correct. So this line will going to shift top equal to top of next. It shift the top pointer to the immediate next element inside the linked list. Then I will immediately assign Q of next equal to null. Where is Q pointer? It is on pointing to topmost element initially, right? So I am assigning Q of next equal to null, so that the Q node is now, topmost node is now completely isolated. After that, I'll apply free Q function to delete that value from the stack. Now talking about display function, it is used to display all the elements of the stack from top element to the null value till the last element of the stack. So again, I'm going to use the Q pointer for traversing. Initially, I will assign Q equal to top. Then again, I will check the underflow condition before display. If Q is null, we can directly say that stack is empty. Else, while Q not equal to null is the condition which has to be checked every time before displaying the information part of the node. If the condition is true, if Q pointer is not null, then display the information part of the node by the line printf Q of info. After that, displaying the information part of the node, to go to the next node, I will use the line Q equal to Q of next. So at the end of this while loop, you will find all the data of the stack will be displayed on the screen. Now we'll check. I'll run and compile the program to check the errors. There are no errors here. There is a warning, you can ignore it. Go to the run and execute it. Now the compiler is asking me to enter my choice. I want to push the element. So option one is entered. Second value is inserted. I want to insert one more element. 30 is inserted, one more element. 40. Now I inserted four elements inside the stack. I want to check how the stack looks like. So I'll give option number 3. The stack consists of the elements 40, 30, 20, 10. Bottommost element is 10, whereas topmost element is 40. Any element that you insert will be inserted at the beginning. So it means that this stack is growing from right to left. This stack is growing from right to left. Right side is the bottom, left side is the top. Try to insert one value, 50 suppose. And check again where 50 gets inserted. It is on top of 40. Check this. On top of 40, on the left hand side, you can see 50 is inserted. So these two functions are working fine. Push and display. Now we'll perform pop function. Now the element which we have inserted recently, which is kept on the top position, will be deleted first. So recently inserted elements are deleted. I inserted now 50, so it will delete 50, which is the topmost element now. Check that. Yes. Now we'll check whether the stack is updated or not. Yes, it is updated. 50 is not there in the stack now. Check. It has 40, 30, 20, and 10. Again, 2. 40 is deleted, 30 is deleted, 20 is deleted. Now I'll check what is there inside the stack. Only 10 is remaining. I will delete that. Now I will check, are there any elements? No, stack is empty. Again, I'll perform pop operation on empty stack. It will show me the error message, stack is empty. Yes, all the functions are working fine. And I want to stop the program now. I will use option number 4 for that. Yes. So all the functions, all the operations are working properly into this program. So you can use this code to implement stack using